Question one, you ready, Jeff?
Mm-hmm, I'm wrong.
What motivates you to actually do what you say you will do?
Many years ago, my mentor told me that you only have two things in your life, your image and your integrity. And far too many people put stock in their image, but make no investment in their integrity. So I try to make sure that my integrity always outweighs my image. It's a basic business principle. Don't let your PR outweigh your production. It's like you're advertising what you don't have. Can you imagine going to McDonald's and they're saying they're out of fries? It's because their PR was too strong for their production. So I want to always make sure whatever it is that I say, I'll follow through on.
Question two, how does a person who is a very devout Christian also understand the importance of actually operating at genius level and understanding the principle that God helps those who help themselves?
I think that there is absolutely no way you can be Christian and embrace ignorance. Everything that Jesus talked about in terms of transformation and conversion was mental. We have reduced it to it being emotional. Jesus in the gospel never asked for our heart. He asked for our mind. He said, you are transformed by the renewing of your mind. And most churches make the appeal, give Jesus your heart, because they want your feelings, but they don't want your thinking. In order for you to replicate who God is, you have to begin to think like him. It's by no accident there are over 200 hills in Jerusalem. But when Jesus was crucified, he was crucified on a place called Golgotha. That word, Golgotha, means the skull. When you then look at it from an aerial perspective, Jesus died for my mind. So his reason for crucifixion was not for me to get a car, not for me to get a house or a job, but so that I could wake up this morning with my mind stayed on him. And so it's the responsibility of those of us who follow Christ to make sure that we have precision in thinking.
Question three, how hard was it for you to keep your personal integrity and leave the church you founded to pastor a church in another city with a bigger congregation? Did you receive any backlash for this, and how did you apply?
The integrity of my call is of such that I followed a biblical model of Abraham, where God said to him, leave everything you know, leave your parents, and go to a place that I will show you. The misnomer is that me leaving my church was an elevation. It was not, it was a sacrifice. I went to a bigger building. I did not go to a bigger congregation. I went to bigger debt. I went to bigger issues. And whenever it is that God calls you, it is to greater risk. Faith is not synonymous with safe. If it's safe, God's not in it. I just finished 18 years at Empowerment Temple in Baltimore, and easily I could have ended my career with another 18, but it really was not the call of God on my life. John Eldridge wrote a book called The Call to the Wild, that every man must have a battle to face, a challenge to endure, and something to love. If they don't have those three, their manhood is incomplete. And I was feeling that I was going back to boyhood wonderment because I was too comfortable at Empowerment. And God had to give me a challenge that would make me a man.
And number four, how have you been able to stand in the face of the fire of your past and move forward with full determination?
Yes. I come through a past where my successes are as high as my failures. And the grace of God that is on my life is that I'm mindful of what one of the former presidents of America said, John Fitzgerald Kennedy, if you ever want to see a great success, look for a great failure. So the evidence of God's hand on my life is that in spite of all of my failures, the successes I have don't match my character. It matches the grace of God.
How has applying genius trait number 5, honesty, helped you?
Honesty has helped me in discovering genius, because it was the Grecian philosopher Aristotle that says, the more I know, the more I know how much I don't know. It is only ignorant people who think that they know everything. That's why you have to always be enrolled as a student of life, ever learning, ever reaching, ever grasping. And so I honestly don't know what I am doing as pastor of New Birth in Stonecrest, Georgia. But I honestly know that God knows a plan, and he's going to use me to pull it together.
How will you use this position to change the world for the better? What would you like your legacy to be?
I think my legacy in coming to New Birth Church is that this is a marriage made in heaven, to show how a pastor and a people can both rebound. We always talk about a phoenix, but the 21st century hasn't seen one. How do you rise from the ashes? You can only rise from the ashes if you've been burned to death. Both New Birth and myself have gone through the flames of opposition, through controversy, through scandal, but the grace of God has kept both of us abounding.